In the past year, my team and I have delivered dozens of updates for our iOS, Android, and Windows Phone apps. Today, I'm excited to share with you some new features in our iOS application, as well as offline support in Android. I'm going to start off by showing some of the exciting new features in our iOS application. A few months ago, we released PDF reading experiences for iOS and Android. When we look at the service, we see that there are billions of PDF documents that have been uploaded, and so we wanted to make that experience a delightful one for you. I'm going to open up a PDF file right now, and you're going to notice that there's a new feature where I can now edit PDF files. I'm going to tap the Edit button. Now that I've done that, you can see there's a number of options that I have. One of the options is that I can highlight some text. Another one of the options is that I can write on the document. Very handy features. But one of the features that I really wanted to show you was the ability to sign a document. In this case, this is a contract. And so what I want to do is go to the last page, where you can see there's a signature field. Bring up the signature. I'm going to select the signature that I've already entered into the application. And as you can see, I can move it anywhere I want on the page. In this case, I'm going to put it right here in the signature field. And then I'm going to hit back. And just like that, now when I share or email or print this PDF file, anybody that looks at it will see all the annotations that I made. The next feature I wanted to show you is some of the work we did to make commanding a little bit easier. We noticed that there are many more large devices out there in the market with large phones and iPads, and it's often a chore to move your fingers all the way down to the bottom of the screen just to do something like share or rename. And so we did some work to build a feature called the flower. As you can see, when I select an item, a couple of commands slide out. And I can select move, I can select delete, I can select information. But right now I'm going to go ahead and select share. And once I select share, I can go ahead and invite one of my colleagues to view the PDF that I just edited. So I'm going to go in and insert their email address and hit add. And now my colleague Ruben is going to get a link to this document, and he'll be able to see all the changes that I've made to the PDF file. Now switching to my Android device. One of the most common requests that we get is the ability to take your files offline, and I'm going to show that to you right now. The first thing I'm going to do is pull out the drawer and select the Offline tab, which is a new tab in the application. And you can see here that the Offline tab explains to me that I can mark my files for offline and access them when I'm on an airplane, for example. So I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going to go select the Fabricam proposal file, and once I have it selected, I'm going to click on the parachute icon. Once I've done that, you can see that the parachute icon now appears next to the file, letting me know that this file is available for offline. But I can also take you right back to the Offline tab, where you can also see that all the files that I've taken offline now appear in one convenient location. This allows me to access all the files that I have offline on an airplane or in a place of low connectivity. These are just some of the highlights of the features my team has built. We're excited for you to get started with these apps today. Please give us feedback on our user voice page. Thanks for watching.